So hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. Hope you all are fine. So guys, if you have been following IPL since it started, that is in 2008, then I'm sure that you would have once or twice felt that how it would have been if the people that are the legends of that time played with the stars of today. So of course it would have been amazing, but practically in real life it's not possible because the legends of that time are retired now. And if at all if you want this to be possible, the only means is through games. And when it comes to mobile games, of course, as you all know, there's no realistic cricket games for mobile with the realistic features. And then we have to move towards the PC games. And in PC games, the best game, as you all know, is EA Cricket 7 because of the patches that keep on coming for it. And from IPL 2008 to 2021, all the year patches are available for this game. But still now, there was no patch in which you can get the best legendary players and could make them play. But finally, that wait of almost 15 years is over, as finally a patch has been released with all these features. And the name of this patch itself is IPL Legends. So this patch has a lot of such awesome and amazing features, guys, about which we'll be discussing later in this video. We'll also show the downloading and installation of this patch. So without further waste of time, let's get into it. So guys, this patch is brought to you by United Studios. And speaking about the features of this patch, first up is that it includes all the Indian stadiums. So yes guys, it includes all the Indian stadiums. And for example, in the Bangalore stadium, you'll get to see that it's completely customized, like the way it looks in the time of IPL. Like the crowd is completely wearing the red uniform, and even it applies to the other stadiums. The second feature is that it features almost all the latest IPL jerseys. As you could see in 2021, the different jerseys of the teams, like the CSK had the military camouflages on their shoulders, so even that is clearly noted down in this patch. So the third and the main and the most important feature of this patch is that it features all the teams of the IPL from 2008 to 2021, like Gujarat Lions, Rising Pune Super Giants, Kochi Tuskers Kerala, Deccan Chargers and the other teams. And speaking about the rosters, guys, this patch features the all-time best rosters of the teams, which means you may not get to see the present generation rosters, but of course you'll get to see the best rosters that the team could ever have. So this is kind of interesting, guys, because that's the main reason of this patch. And speaking about the menu, it's really very amazing, guys, because they have made a kind of 3D menu which is really very good. And then the overlays change the feeling of the game, guys. Because of the gold shade, the feel of the game itself goes to the next level, guys. And speaking about international jerseys, of course this patch also features the international jerseys, guys, through which you can also call this patch as a mega patch. But still, I like the IPL feature of this patch, guys. And the coolest thing about this patch is that despite of offering so many features, this patch is not paid, guys, it's completely free. So these are some of the basic features of this patch, guys. So now let's move towards the downloading and installation of it. So guys, first of all, you need to turn your antivirus off, and then you need to go to the description box of this video. So I would have given you a link there. Just open the link and download this IPL Legends installer file, guys. So after downloading, now let's move towards the installation process. So guys, here I have a IPL Legends installer file, guys. So along with this, you'll also require a freshly installed EA Cricket 7 for this patch to take place. So now first we need to open this IPL Legends installer file, guys. So it will take a bit of time to open, so just be patient. So after it opens up, you need to click on next, and again you need to click on next and click on I agree with the terms and conditions and click on next. And here when it asks you a path, click on this three dot option and give the location where you have installed your EA Cricket 7, guys. And remember, you need to have a freshly installed EA Cricket 7, guys. Then you need to click on next and click on start, and then it will take a bit of time to install, guys. So let's sit back. So guys, now our patch is successfully installed into our game. So now we just need to click on next, and then you need to click on exit and exit this installer. So now you need to go to the location where you have installed your EA Cricket 7, because that's where our patch is now installed. So guys, now as you can see, I've come into the game location of EA Cricket 7, and as you can see, the patch is already installed out here, but there are some small formalities that we have to do. So first of all, let's open this add-ons folder, and then you need to open this roster folder, and then you need to copy this one and go to documents EA Cricket 7 and paste it out there. So by the way, this would already be done, guys. I mean, as you install your patch, automatically the roster would be fitted into its place, but by some reason, if it is not present out there, you can manually paste it. So guys, now let's go back to our add-ons folder. So here you'll get to see three folders known as batsman with naked head, batsman with brim, and batsman with cap. So this is basically your batsman's appearance, guys. If you want your batsman to appear without any helmet or cap like MS Dhoni, you can go for the batsman with naked head. If you want him to wear a hat or something, you can go with batsman with brim. If you want him to wear a classic cap, just go to batsman with cap. So for now, I want him to be in a naked head, so I'm gonna go with batsman with naked head. So for that, you just need to open the folder, guys, and after opening, you just need to copy all the files present out here except the back to normal folder. And after copying, you just need to go back to your EA Cricket 7's file location and paste all these files out there. And while pasting, it would ask for some copy and replacing. Just click on yes, guys. So now let's come back to our add-ons folder, and if at all you want your batsman to wear your helmets back, just go to that folder, click on back to normal, copy and paste these files into the file location. And guys, another interesting feature about this patch is that they provide a camera angle patch also, guys. So basically, you'll get to see two types of camera angle patch. One is a DBC style camera angle patch, which you'll get to see in DBC 14 and DBC 17 game. One more is a realistic camera angle patch. So you can use any one of them. I'll show in detail the difference between both of them. So for now, I'll use the DBC style camera angle patch. For that, you just need to copy that particular folder, I mean the file, and you need to go to EA Cricket 7's file location and paste it out there. And after doing that, guys, you can also open this for widescreen folder. You'll get to see an application known as resolution changer. So this is completely optional, guys. So to use this, you just need to open the application, then click on open and select your particular profile which you use in your EA Cricket 7 game. And then you can select your resolution, details, and shadows accordingly, guys. So I have already done it, so I'm not gonna change anything out here. And after you make the requirements according to your needs, just click on save and then exit it, guys. So now let's go back, guys, and let's open this kits folder. So you'll get to see different types of kits out here, like the DC version 2 and other things. Let's discuss about it later. For now, let's open this profile, guys. And now if you're having a 32-bit PC, open 32-bit. If you're having 64-bit, open 64-bit. So I have a 32-bit, so I'm gonna open 32-bit. Copy this folder, go to documents, EA Cricket 7, and paste it up there. So this is very necessary if you want your camera angle patch to function properly, guys. So now let's go back to our add-ons folder and check out about what's remaining. So I forgot to close this resolution changer app. Let me close it and let's go back. So first let's open this overlay file, guys, and there you'll get to see two types of overlays. One is the Sony 6 version and other is the Star Sports version. I'll show the difference between both of them later. First I'll go with the Star Sports version, guys. So you just need to copy all these files, come back to the EA Cricket 7 file location and paste it out there, guys. So here you'll also get to see an umpire face editor kind of thing, guys. But for that, you'll also require an application known as player editor, and it's a kind of hectic job, guys. So I'm not gonna show the tutorial out here, guys. Sorry for that. And now let's open our kits folder and check out what's in it. So guys, here you'll get to see different types of kits of the different teams, guys. So you'll get to see the kits of almost all the teams, and as you all know, the DC version 2 is also available out here, and you'll also get to see the RCB blue and RCB green kits out here. So the kits of Kochi Tuskers Kerala, Gujarat Lions, and the other teams are included. So for now, I'll put in the RCB green kit, guys. So for that, I need to open the RCB green folder, copy these files, go to the file location of EA Cricket 7 and paste it out there, guys. And guys, don't forget to copy and replace your files. If you don't copy and replace, then nothing is gonna get updated. So now let's open once again this add-ons folder. Let's open the kits folder, and I'll also show you the umpire one, guys. So just open the umpire folder, copy these both files, go back to EA Cricket 7's file location and paste it out there. So guys, now we are done with all the installation procedures. So there's only one small procedure remaining. For that, we need to open the game. And guys, to launch the game in this patch, you'll get to see two kind of files. So one is run this game using this exe, and one more is widescreen by AnnaTest. So if you want a widescreen view in your game, open the widescreen one. If you want a normal view, open the run game using this exe. If this method does not work, launch your game normally using the Cricket 7 icon, guys.
United Studios IPL Legends patch.
So guys, the game begins with an amazing intro, and after you start your game, click on My Cricket, go to load or save, click on load, go to roster section and load this IPL LEG roster, guys. So now let's start a match and check out how it looks like. So guys, the overlay is looking really very amazing, and as I said, it's in a 3D overlay kind of thing. The stadiums are also really very very amazing, guys. The camera angle is also really very good, guys. So now let's go and change the camera angle and the overlays and check out how the game looks like, guys. So guys, the menu is looking really very cool, guys. Yeah, it's not in 3D, but it's still looking really very good. The overlays are completely realistic, like the 2016 ones, and it is also really very good, guys, and the camera angle is also very good. So guys, with this we come to the end of our video, guys, and if you like the content that we have provided in this video, then don't forget to like it, guys, because your one like means a lot to us, guys. It gives us a lot of motivation. And as you go, don't forget to subscribe the channel, guys. Your one subscribe can make us a day, guys, and we have put in a lot of effort in making this video, so your subscription is always gonna be worth us. And guys, comment down below on what topic you want our next video to be on. And guys, we'll meet you in the next video. Until then, stay tuned, take care, and